Hello, you beautiful people. I'm Michael Botz, and we are talking about the speed of success, and today we're going to go over number six. I thought today was going to be the last day, but it's not. The more I meditate on this, the more that I start to just think about it, we are not going to finish on number six. There is more to talk about if you want to go the speed of success. This is what we know for sure. This is the foundation of this whole show, of this whole tribe. We are born genius. We are born epic. We are born to impact the world in a way that only we, each of us individually, can impact the world. When our expiration date shows up, the world can never be impacted that way again. So you're born with I am enough on your DNA. Okay? I am enough. I just want that to soak in. Now, as I say it, your brain is starting to run back. The little U's in your brain are starting to run back all the way back to when you were born and go, yeah, he's right. I was born. I am enough. And here I can prove it to you. Have you ever heard of the little baby, maybe 2.5 pounds, born with her heart outside of her chest and she survives? How could that little baby survive if she didn't have I am enough on her DNA? And each of us have a story like that about ourselves, something that we survived. And the only explanation is I am enough. So you go along completely failing and not caring. You failed at walking, you failed at talking, you failed at eating. Absolutely, epically failed. But you also succeeded at it. Look at you now, walking around, talking around, eating around all fancy, using a fork, drinking out of a cup, and there's nothing on your shirt. Woo! Look at you. That was all out of I am enough. You never see a baby push away mama's milk at night because the baby's like, Mom, I can't have any milk tonight. I can't sleep. I'm so stressed. I haven't walked. I'm not talking yet. When I eat, I get spaghetti all over me. I'm so stressed. I'm failing miserably. Oh, it's terrible. You never, ever, ever hear a baby. You saw a baby do that. And that's because the baby's in I am enough. But then you get caught in the riptide of life. And you get sucked out into the ocean of am I enough. And in the ocean of am I enough, you're still trying to succeed because of I am enough. But now you're starting to get labels. Labels you put on yourself. Labels that the people that raised you said about themselves that you accept as truth for you. I'm fat. I'm lazy. I'm really athletic, but I'm not really smart. I'm clumsy. I'm really smart, but I'm not athletic. I can't finish anything. I'm always going to be at the bottom. Nothing ever works out for me. We always run out of money before we run out of month. It goes on and on. And these are all weights that you start to carry and drown in the ocean of am I enough? And then you show up to this show. You get me in your life. You buy my book and read a page out of it every day like a workbook for success. And it's like I'm grabbing you and dragging you back up onto the beach of I am enough. And I start to resuscitate you and blow in your mouth. And you, all of a sudden, your eyes open and you realize and you start to spew out doubt, fear, and limiting beliefs. And you take these breaths and I am enough is start to revive in you. And then I stand you up and I aim you down the path of success. And what do we know about the path of success, tribe? It is paved in gratitude. This part of the show is always going to be about gratitude. So now is your opportunity to say, and I'm grateful. Oh, Laura Carroll, she had it ready. She pushed push. I love that. Thank you, Laura Carroll, for your participation. Every single day she's here. Every single day she participates. And I cannot express enough gratitude for that. Laura Cole says, I'm grateful for a nice, warm house. I'm proud that I've taken great care of myself, and I am enough. Woo! As it gets cold, how about a warm house? When it's raining, how about a roof over your head? When it's really cold, how about a warm blanket and a warm bed? I'm with you, Laura Carroll. I'm with you. Absolutely, positively. And you are enough. And you do take care of yourself. You're teaching yoga. You're going to Zumba. You're eating right. I am so proud of you. Thank you for being a great example for all of us. All right. Now, as you're putting in your gratitudes, we're going to take some breaths. These breaths are to create space. Because what do we know, tribe? What do we know for sure? One of the things that absolutely no one's going to argue with is life is hard. And this morning when you woke up, peeked over the sheets, life was standing there ready to start swinging at you. And life will swing at you with all kinds of different stuff. Whatever your weakness is, life is going to try to hand that to you. Whatever you're stressed about, life's going to pile it on. Oh, what the doctor diagnosed you with. The history, your health history, and you're so, life's going to hand you, mom, your grandma had it, your mom had it, you're going to have it. Money, what about finances? Life will just start handing you the question of, are you going to succeed? Are you going to make it this month? What about the mortgage? How about college, paying for kids' college? How about payroll? Huh, payroll's brutal. So life just starts swinging at you as soon as you woke up. And now we're just taking punches up against the cage. And these breaths are going to create space. Say it, space. And that space is where the answer is, where the solution is, where your next step is. Take these breaths. It matters. All right. Ready? Breathe in. Say, I am enough. See, when you say something out your mouth, it goes in your inner ear, down in your soul. Now your soul and the universe are collaborating to make more of that happen. We're going to do three more. We're going to finish with I am enough on each breath. Remember, we're creating space. Become mindful and soulful and notice the answer in the space. Ready? Breathe in. I am enough. Breathe in. I am enough. One more. Breathe in. Let it out. I am enough. All right. All right. Again, we're talking about the speed of success. We went through these subjects in great detail. Who, where, what, when. And yesterday we talked about your why. Why are you going to go through this? Why are you going to put yourself through it? Today we're going to talk about ask why. Always be asking why. Why? You know, there's this great story. I think it's a great story. I'm going to tell it to you, and you can let me know if you think it's a great story. Of this lady, she's cooking the ham for Thanksgiving. We got Thanksgiving coming up, and she's cutting off the ends of the ham. And she puts it on the table, and, you know, everybody enjoys it and everywhere. And afterwards, the husband says, "Why do you cut the ends of the ham off? I love the end of the ham. That's my favorite part. Why do you keep cutting it off when you make a ham?" Well, she says, "I don't know. Mom did that." So the next time they're at mom's house, the husband and the wife are like, "Mom, why do you cut off the ends of the ham?" She says, "Oh, I don't know. Grandma did it." And so they go to grandma's house. They see grandma at Christmas or whatever. And they're like, "Grandma, why do you cut off the ends of the ham before you cook it?" And she says, "Oh, I always did that because my pan, the ham, wouldn't fit in the pan if I didn't cut the ends off. So the grandma did it because the pan was too big. The mom did it because the grandma did it. The daughter did it because the mom did it because the grandma did it. The point of the story is, I want you, in your business, if you want to go the speed of success, to start asking why." Now, Here's the deal. You have to ask in a certain way. You have to have a certain mindset when you ask. You cannot ask why like a 17-year-old teenage girl. That is like, why? Why do I have to do this? It has attitude. It needs to be right. It has an agenda. Do not ask why with like a 17-year-old teenage girl. What I want you to do is I want you to ask why like the 6-year-old girl. She just says, Mommy, why? Why do we stop at this? Why is there a stop sign here? Well, there's a stop sign here because if no one stops, someone would get hurt. It's an innocent way to ask why. And when you ask why in this way, you will start matching the speed of success. Because there are things you're doing in your business that there is a better way. There is no need to do it. And the reason you've done it is because you did it that way when you were broke. You did it that way when you didn't have someone to do it. You always need to be asking why. You know, I had a client, and our first time we sat down, he brought his profit and loss statement. And we're looking at the marketing, and the marketing was like, I think it was $12,000 a month. And I was like, okay, great. I mean, I'm all about marketing. You have to market to become a powerhouse in the marketplace. Tell me what that brings in. And he didn't know. He didn't know what the $12,000 is bringing in. He had just done it, made the commitment, hired the person, and just kept paying it. And I was like, well, let's start checking this. For the next 30 days, I want you to see how much comes in from that $12,000. We were asking why. I'm getting him to the speed of success in his business, and one of the things we did was we asked why. 60 days, the marketing wasn't doing anything. This was not a new marketing, like, okay, it needs 120 days to start impacting. This was something he had been doing, and it was having zero impact. It was bringing zero money into the company. $12,000 a month he saved by asking why. Each of us need to be asking why. Now, if you are in a company, you have your own side hustle. That's probably why you're here. You're here to get motivated, to get focused, to have your own business. But also, if you're in a company, ask why. You can move up the echelon by asking why. You need to ask respectfully. Again, like a little 6-year-old girl. She just asks why because she wants to know why you're doing it that way. And then investigate all the way back to why the ham ends were cut off. Because the pan was too small. We don't need to cut the ends of the ham off anymore. Each of us today is going to have some profound thing. Why do we do it that way? Because we've always done it that way. Because the father of the father of the father of the company of the founders did it that way. Okay, I love that. I love tradition. I'm all about it. Now, is it productive today in today's technology? Why do we have a landline? Right there. That could save you $100 a month. Why do you have a landline? Well, in case it goes out. Your landline could go out too. I'm just using examples because I want you to wake up and start asking the question, why? But you have to ask it without needing to be right, without resentment, without an agenda. Just asking simply why. And then you just listen. Why am I paying you $12,000 a month for marketing? And then just listen, innocently, without any resentment, without any agenda, just like the 6-year-old girl just says, why? And we've all been around those kids, and they'll just keep asking why, and keep asking why. Why? Why is there a stop sign here? Well, because people, okay, then why did they do that? And it just keep, and they just narrow you down to your bone marrow asking you why. We need to be like that, without an agenda, without trying to be right, just getting the answers. If we ask why more often with innocence and learning and anticipation, we can set ourselves up to go the speed of success. I love you. I care about you. I love you. Do you know I love you? I want you to know, if no one else tells you today, I love you. If you need it today, if today you're thinking about, man, I'm just going to quit. I'm going to quit the whole deal. I can't do it anymore. I want to encourage you. I love you. You can go another day. Get out there and dominate today. Have a great day.